Golden Bowling Ball Brunswick Tour was presented by Brunswick. Bowling is sold on Brunswick worldwide.
Been Berlin, but he's been around, as you can see, for quite a number of years. He's qualified in fourth place, 23rd after the first round. The cut then that divides the top 88, who go forward, the rest go home. And he moved into the final four to take on the number three seed, Lassi Lintilä from Finland, a familiar figure to us on the Golden Bowling Ball Tour. And that might just be the final smile you see from Lasse over the next half an hour or so, depending on how far he goes in the men's stepladder final. First up then, Bodo Konietzny, the German, who will begin. The winner of this game goes forward to take on our Swedish participant in the final four. That's Johan Damberg, and he'll sit back now to enjoy what's going to happen over the next 10 frames and maybe try to read the lanes early and get some feel for what's happening out there on our TV pair. 27 and 28 being used for the men's stepladder final. Konietzny away with a 9 count and a simple spare. 223 was the average needed to get him into fourth place. So starts with a relaxed smile and sits down as Lasse now will bowl the next two frames, and Bodo will finish. Bodo still smiling. Lasse concentrating on a nasty split to open up for him. The 30-year-old vastly experienced Finnish international. What a superb effort that is right off the bat in frame one. Crowd enjoying that. Lintilä currently third in the Masters rankings with 7,981 points. World Team Cup winner 12 months ago, and also figuring last year in Dresden in the men's stepladder final there, where he came in third place. So want to improve on that today. But a hesitant start at the moment for the more experienced man. They say he has ice in his veins, and this time he can't get the spare. In fact, easier than the 4-9 he took out in frame one. So the 2-4-5-8 grouping defeats Lasse Lintilä, and he has an open frame in the second. The count then behind the spare is just 25 from the first two. Bodo with the Spandau bowling team in Berlin. I think he likes a bit of Spandau Ballet. He was telling me earlier on that he's really into the disco music. Spandau bowling team, one of the strongest in the German league, and they've given Bodo a platform to go on and become a fully fledged senior international. He's got a handy start here as he moves forward to frame three. Right hander. There was the hook, right into the sweet spot, and a double. So we'll sit down while Lasse now has another two shots back to back, but won't be able to assail Bodo's early lead. He needs to come back strongly after the open frame in the second. That's better from Lintilä, more like the style we're used to seeing from him. Looking for the sweet spot, there it is, from our overhead camera. No doubt about that one. So his first strike comes in the third frame. Intense concentration from the man who runs a bowling center of his own up there in Finland. So now he's locked in after the early stumble. Nice deep knee bend, as you saw. Head perfectly still. And those laser beam eyes hooking onto the sweet spot. And down went the ball unerringly to do the rest. Konietzky still with the lead, however. Needs a little tap on that 10 and gets it. That'll do for three in a row. Well done to him. This is a very, very good start indeed from the underdog. Opened up with a spare and now three strikes running. 25 pins the difference. The German in frame five. Can he make it four? Just coming in a little light. Wasn't quite getting back. Some contact on the head pin, the number one pin. But not enough to carry all 10. So that was a slight error of judgment. There comes the bite point, and you see from the overhead, though he takes out the one pin, not enough contact through the pack, and the 8-5 remain. Well, this should be meat and drink to a man of Konietzky's stature. So he has three strikes and two spares from the opening five frames. And at the moment, it's pacing around a 2-3-5 game. Well, the guys need to perhaps up that pin average by 10 pins when you get to the stepladder stage, as the competition intensifies. That's textbook stuff from Lintilä, who's now right into the groove. And he has a three-bagger. That was his shot in frame five. Still playing catch-up, however. Lassie always goes through the same setup routine. On its way, and another one. So now that just tightens the screw a little, and we'll put some pressure onto Bodo, who's going to be the first to crack. They're pacing each other now, stalking each other like tigers. Strike being answered with strike. Now it's light again. Carsten Hartmann, the young coach of Bodo. He's just fractionally too far right, and it makes all the difference. It's another light hit on the head pin. And this time the result is the 2-8. 5-8 it was last time. This is a tough one, and he's missed the two. He's too far right of the first of those two, and the 8 was the sleeper pin. Well, the reaction brought the ball back, tripped out the 8. But missed the two pin. Now he's got an open frame in the 6. And I suspect that was all brought about by the 4 strikes in a row from his opponent, which just added to the pressure shot. And what can he do in frame 7? I suspect his lead is about to disappear, but that's good. Good response. Look at the crowd that's packed in here today. All 10 in the pit. That's what a bowler loves to see. So Lintilä again, before every shot, takes that ball, dries the thumb hole over the dryer, and locks in on those chevrons, you see, as the ball now crosses them down to the heads, as we call them in bowling. And what about that for a sequence? 5 in a row for the ice-cold killer from Finland. and he jumps into the lead. Three frames to go. Lasse with the advantage. We're going to take a short break. Well, the Brunswick US Play Centre abuzz here as Lasse Lintilä has clawed his way back into this game and now jumped into a healthy 20-pin lead. And he's really on fire. He's going for six in a row. He's slightly across the head pin this time. And in frame eight, the sequence broken. He leaves a 3-pin standing. Right-hander here goes across the pocket. See, he misses the angle of entry, 1-3. And you're not going to get a strike like that. Using that spare ball. So at the end of frame eight now, Lintilä ahead by 20, and he'll close out the game. Right on the nose with that one. Okay. It's a good shot from Bodo. That's an unlucky break. 10-pin remains. It's a good shot. Tapio Vuorinen, who goes everywhere with the Finnish bowlers to all the Golden Bowling Ball Tour events, which is obligatory, incidentally, from the federations in both Scandinavian countries, Sweden and Finland. All their top bowlers have to attend every Golden Bowling Ball Tour stop. Well, sparing is not going to help Bodo's chances of progressing anymore. It has to be strikes from here on in. Well, he has one in the foundation frame in the ninth. Very important shot, that, to keep him alive. Otmar Zicek and Josef Gablek just behind Bodo. Match referees from the Viennese bowling scene. He's pretty happy about that last shot. That kept him in the game. Now Lasse, five in a row, missed last time out when he crossed the head pin. Oh, he's got a lucky break this time. That's cruel. The game of bowling can be fickle. It didn't happen for Kuznetsny in his eighth frame attempt when he left a solid 10 with an identical shot, but the one pin comes right across the pin deck and takes out that 10. Thank you very much. So it's Lasse Lintilä then into the final frame, and just adding up the scores, he needs a strike and six pins behind a strike ices his opponent and puts him into the second round. But it must be a strike with the first ball. Yes, and it is. And that should be enough for the 30-year-old from Nummela. Wife Pia looking on. Has one baby daughter coming up to 2 years of age. And his game went slightly off the boil around the time of Julia's birth, understandably, but he's right back to his best. And, well, he's taken out nine there, just needed the six. So he's home and dry. And if he converts with a final shot, he has indeed done exactly as we suggested. He's upped his average from qualification, 210 to make the first cut. Then it was up to 227 for Lasse. And he's got one better in this first round match in the stepladder final. 233, the score for a man who opened with two open frames against Bodo Konietzny and then struck seven of the next eight to put himself into a matchup with old foe from Sweden, Johan Damberg. So fourth place finish for the 24-year-old from Berlin. Now just going through the motions as he wraps up his 10th and final frame. And to come here after that nine count. A shot for that spare, the 10 once again proving the problem. and a 2-1-4. So Lass has turned a 23-pin deficit into a stunning 19-pin win after starting with those two open frames, and he's done it with seven strikes from the remaining eight frames. That is magnificent, consistent bowling. A three-bagger when Bodo seemed to be reading the lanes perfectly, but suddenly that became a minefield of uncertainty. Out he goes and step forward, Johan Damberg from Gothenburg. It's a Sweden-Finland matchup next. And whenever that happens in worldwide bowling, we know we're in for something very special. There won't be too much body language, there won't be too many smiles and words exchanged between these two very, very competitive top European bowlers. Well, this is one to sit back and savour. Here we go. Game two. Damberg away with a nine count, leaving the seven. Now we have a left-hander to admire, as you see, and he takes the wide outside line, flirting with the channel. And that means he trusts himself and hopes he's reading the break point in the lane to bring that ball back a long way. You really need nerves of steel, a steady eye, and a very experienced hand to be able to play this sort of game. Look how close he goes to that channel, but that's right on the nose. So Damberg opens up with a spare. Hendrik Nielsen is his coach and sponsor. All the top Scandinavians receiving financial support from sponsors and their federations. And that's why they're leading the rest in men's bowling right across Europe. You're looking at the two top nations here going head to head in Vienna. No shot from Lasse, and that really was a bonus strike for Lintilä. Eight from the last nine now. Every time he steps up to the foul line, fortune seems to be favouring him. Bowls for the Remy Kings in his home city of Loga, near Nymela. That's just north of Helsinki. Remy actually means the gutter kings. It's a bit of a bowling in joke. Obviously, putting the ball in the gutter is the one thing you never want to do, and these guys very rarely do it, so good are they. But a little tongue-in-cheek humour for the name of his local club there up in Finland, the Gutter Kings. Now let's admire the style of 30-year-old Johan Damberg from Gothenburg. He's single and works in the cable TV business. Installation is his game. Well, he'll be hoping to install himself into the final matchup here with our top seed, Frank Berner. Just 67th in the first round after six matches, averaging 208, but that was comfortably inside the 88 that were needed to go forward to round two. Then he upped the average considerably and started to really hit the strikes with some solid play, 230. And that got him into this stepladder final as the second seed. So he's quite happy sparing at the moment. And what he needs as we come forward to frame three is a strike. Right on cue for Damberg. Bowls for the Joker Club in Gothenburg. That's another very formidable European bowling outfit. It was nice to see a lefty in the finals. Confirmation of Lass's win in game one. And he certainly should be feeling confident. And this is for a Turkey, and he's got it too. Well, making his intentions clear right from the off. 10 strikes for Lasse Lintilä from the last 11 frames of play. Well, this is his opponent, Damberg's second consecutive TV final. He was the winner last time out in Dresden, but he's not looking too happy at the moment. Now then, Lasse for number four. Will it be in the fourth? Well, that was a weak one. Probably heard there. Contact with ball and pins. Soft shot. Seven count, 3-6-10 the leave. Plows through the head pin. So the first misjudgment from the Finn with the cold fish eyes. It's Mrs. Lindela. Pia looking on. She'll do the smiling for the Lindela household. That's a good spare conversion, however. And just explaining to the coach how he got that last shot wrong. Into frame four for Johan. And that's a double. Michael Herting, our host here this weekend. Playing that outside line again. Maybe he needed a couple of frames just to find the bite point. Here it comes. There it is. Oh, no, it's a washout. 1-3-7. You can get a three or a four-pin washout. And that also the result of a soft shot. Well, missed the head pin entirely. You don't take out the one pin. There's no way in the world you're ever going to get a strike. This is a toughie. Mm-hmm. Now there's a problem for the Swede. That's the Swedish champion of 1997 in singles play. And also the European five-man team gold medalist from 97. Well, I can only assume that the heads are beginning to dry out a little now under the TV lights. It does happen. And the players know it's going to happen at some point in the final, because that ball is turning too early for both players. And two consecutive shots now from the masterful Finnish player has taken him across the head pin, and again left him with a seven count. He converted last time. Can he do it here with the 3-6-10? No, he can't. One of the wonderful curios of bowling is that when your opponent opens up, suddenly you do the same. And Lasse there had a chance to jump out into a big lead. So a little more tape going on to that zone ball in the thumb hole, slipping off the hand too early, and that's why it was crossing the head pin. See if he's worked it out after this break. Welcome back to a very tense atmosphere here, lane side in Vienna. Both players have opened up in frame five. Leading at the midpoint is the Finn by just 11. Now he's made that adjustment, more tape has gone into the thumb hole. And this time he's got the rotation just about right, but he doesn't get a strike. Got the benefit of good pinfall earlier on in this game, but this time the 10 remains standing. The man whose ambition is to be world champion in 1999 in Abu Dhabi. Every 4 years the world championships come around. We're in the Middle East this year. It was Reno 4 years ago. And there he is doing the business once again with that rhino glow on the spares. The man who likes a little fishing, loves basketball, big fan of Michael Jordan, that's his sporting hero. And he follows the Utah Jazz. And he's calling the tune at the moment in this second of three games in the men's stepladder final. But here comes Damberg. No doubt now the lane conditions are changing almost frame by frame. Left-hander needs a lucky break, and this time he gets it, a double. Through 6 and 7, Alain Winterhalter, vice president from Brunswick International. And just behind him, also enjoying the play, Bernard Morin, our good friend, who publishes the leading French bowling magazine and never misses a major tournament. So Lasse has just seen his opponent come back from his open with a double. And he's going in frame seven. Could only spare last time out. It's a great shot. That's a championship winning shot. Oh, this is game on, and you can sense the Austrian crowd are really loving every minute. Five pin game now. Well, Lasse just by a pin on that graphic, but it all depends what the boys follow in behind their strikes. Can he double up? Ooh, it was good, it was good. And bowling does that to you sometimes. Just jumps up and hits you right between the eyes. So he gets nothing on the 10 pin here. And that's unlucky. Six pin went round behind it off the wall, no touch. Classic encounter, crowd hushed. Pink spare ball does it again. And many of the bowlers have stayed on to enjoy this final as well. So now it is just one pin the difference. This for three, oh no. That would have been a turkey. But that's come at just the wrong time for Johan. 3, 5, 6, 9. No, he's missed the back pin. And he's opened up. And I suspect he's been pummeled and ground down by the superior mental game of Lasse Lintilä. I think it could have all gone with that shot in the eighth. That's a better response. In the ninth frame from the Swede. But at this moment, I'd say not favourite to become the first man to win back-to-back on the Golden Bowling Ball Brunswick Tour. So Lasse into frame nine. Now he's back with a healthy advantage after a second open frame from the Swede. Uncharacteristically in frame eight, really did let a loose one go. Is a fantastic spare converter, Lasse. Has missed once. On this telecast, all got hung up at the foul line. You saw that briefly. Immediately looked down. There was no slide into the foul line, but he got away with it. The ball was on its way, and all done from the arm. It was good enough. So again, he has the opportunity to keep his opponent in his seat and close out the game. Again, his fate in his own hands, but this time the task in hand is altogether tougher. Two strikes with the first two shots in the 10th. It looks like one of them. Yes, it is. Now he gives himself two bonus balls at the end of the 10th. This is where you pump up that score. And another one will put him into the final. Here he goes, needs all 10. And he's got it. He's got it. He's through. When the questions were answered, this man came through. The fin is flying once again. And who says he doesn't want it? So this is for fun now, because Danberg has gone the way of Bodo Konietzny. The final count with that 9 is 2-11. Well, it's well below the average we've seen from Lasse over the last 2 days. But it wasn't so much about pin tally in that game. That really was a mental game of chess out on the bowling lanes. And Lasse reigns supreme. So a rather dispirited Johan Damberg will be heading back to Gothenburg. And a third place finish behind the victory last time out in Dresden is what he takes home, I'm sure, along with many wonderful souvenirs and memories, as we've all had such a great time this weekend in the Austrian capital. But Vienna, not a happy place for Johan Damberg. And he's come up against the Iceman. Lasse Lindeler does it again. So had his one moment of doubt with an open in frame five, showed again that formidable mental toughness in the 10th to close out the game and go forward to face our top seed, already a winner on the Golden Bowling Ball Tour in front of the TV cameras last year. It's the bad boy of German bowling from Tübingen. He's back, Frank Berner. So what a final. It's probably the one the crowd, the sponsors, and the players themselves wanted to see. If they couldn't be in it, then it just took my breath away for a moment there. This is probably the classic confrontation. Top seed, the gritty, the Mr. Unpredictable, the Mr. Big Mouth of German bowling, Frank Berner, has put himself out of the German national side with comments made to the Federation, the coaches, and some of his fellow internationals. It has to be said, he's not the most popular man amongst the German bowling fraternity, but he is a winner, and so is this man. Oh, this is going to be some final. So Berner began, and that means he will finish. They both open up with strikes. Current form, you're possibly seeing certainly two from the top five European bowlers out on the tour this year. How fitting they should go head-to-head for us today in Vienna in front of the Eurosport cameras. Lasse looking for a crossover strike. Germany's Andrea Mirscher looking on. Fine lady bowler in her own right. For the spare, yes, 6-10, no problem. Fifth in the Masters in Frankfurt last year, almost certain to be in the Masters again this season in Lille, first weekend in June, make a date for your diary. And once again, out comes the tape around that all-important thumb hole. So the winner of two tour stops, Frank Berner from Tübingen in the south of Germany, now 38 years of age, and as you see, another left-hander. Some people say that's an advantage. Obviously the left side of the lane gets far less action with the majority of players bowling as right-handers. That's Frank's action. It's a soft hit from him in frame two, and he has 2-4-8 standing for his spare. Frank, not a man to hide his emotions. When his game is up and bubbling, he looks as if he could run through a brick wall, but things get under his skin very quickly. He's a little hot-tempered and a little bit quick to speak his mind at times. And that's not going to help his mental game. Hans Nitsch is coaching Frank Berner here today. Married to Melanie, also has a young family. In fact, her son Daniel born just a couple of weeks ago, and he says that should he win today, that win will be dedicated to his young son. Strike in the first, open in the second, but a strike in frame three. For your number one seed, Frank Berner arrived in this final with a 2.38 average. And I would think something around 2.40 might be necessary to take the trophy. Yes, he's got it. Nice pin action, good break. And early advantage to Lintilä, who's come through from third position and looking to win his third game in a row to take the title in Vienna and finally break his duck on the Golden Bowling Ball Brunswick Tour. Can he do it? We have seven frames to find out. Coming your way after this. Don't go away. Welcome back. It was Swedes winning in Hamburg and Dresden on the first two tour stops of the season. Lasse Lintilä looking to be the first Finn to win out on tour this year. Well, back we go. He has a 12-pin lead coming in behind a strike in frame three. He's left himself with a 6-pin conversion for a spare in frame four. Right-hander playing a left-hander, crosses the head pin. So still having to adjust his game as we get through the final phase of our stepladder final. Hitting the pocket high has been a problem for Lasse, but he gets himself out of jail again because he is such a good spare shooter. Michael Herting wondering whose name he's going to be putting on the winner's check. So Frank, two times a tour winner on the Brunswick Tour. Yes, it's gone. And only just in the nick of time. That was the kingpin, the five, dancing around on the pin deck and finally falling just before the resetting machine came down. And had that touched the pin before it hit the deck, that would have not been a valid strike. So intervention from our match referee not needed, as you saw from the replay, but it couldn't have been closer. Burner into frame five looks for the turkey. And gets it, doesn't quite have the deep outside line we saw from the Swede in the previous game. So something for Lasse to think about. And you can see he's over adjusted. Having got the break point wrong last time up and cross that head pin, that's what inevitably happens when you follow in with a light hit. See, he's gone too far right, never gives it a chance to get back to the pocket. And a light hit, seven count, 2-4-5 is the leave. Fifth frame, and I think the leadership is about to change hands. Comfortable again when it comes to shooting spares, but skidding too long with the first shot. Now he's had two spares back to back. This could be a very important shot indeed. Yes, he's read it right that time. Must have been playing on his nerves, because that's the first time in this final he's managed to get a strike over on that lane. Good shot from the German. This is a handy sequence now he's putting together. Four in a row for Berner. The ambition here this weekend, he said, was just to keep winning Golden Bowling Ball Tour events, not just for the money and the prestige. He also needs to get himself into the rankings for the Masters final. He's well down at the moment. But of course, missing in Dresden with the impending birth of baby Daniel. Looking for five, not this time. In frame seven, leaves a 2-pin. Certainly the back end's now getting very dry. That ball hit the one pin a little too straight. That's why he left the two. Down it goes. So he also beginning to lose the break point and just rolled a little too early on the first shot. It's very technical out there. It's very tactical. And I can tell you it's even up here. Very, very tense. That looks good. That's much better. So he had a point to prove here in the mid phase of this final match. Lasse Lindhe had suddenly seen his first shot overreacting and then underreacting on both TV final pairs, lanes 27 and 28. He's had to make that adjustment and he's done so. Look at that, he's got a double going. And can he make it three in a row? He's going to put himself in great shape for the final two frames if he can. And here he comes again, Lasse Lindhe. Had the lead, lost the lead. Right back at Burner's throat. Nothing in this game. Some deep breathing. I can promise you I have seen Lasse smile. I'll never forget it once. It was at Tolworth in 1990. That was the last time. But he might be smiling today if he walks away with 50,000 Deutschmarks. Great stuff. Really digging deep, Burner. He hasn't been playing as much this season. He's one of those lucky men in life who combines his hobby with his work. Employed in a bowling center. The family commitments have kept him away from the lanes. Bowls, of course, for the Tübingen side. NBC Tübingen in his home city. And right now, 157, 127 with two strikes to come to fill in Lasse's scoreline. This is a dead even game. You couldn't have a better final. Well, one surefire way to make sure you're not going to be overhauled is to keep striking. So, through to frame nine. And six frames in seven have resulted in strikes for that man, Frank Burner. And Lasse now into the end game will bowl nine and ten back to back. And he too has got to keep striking. Or hope that Burner folds up in the 10th frame. All the pressure right now is on the Finn. This is a crucial shot. No. Never looked like taking out the 6-10. End of his little sequence. He's not able to win now by his own efforts, only if Burner does something really disastrous in the 10th frame. I'm sure he's going to spare this without any problems. The only hope now for Lasse Lindhe. Tantalizingly close once again, but still looking as if he's got to wait another tour stop for that elusive first Golden Bowling Ball Brunswick Tour win. He's got to pray that Burner does something really stupid in the 10th. So this is his bonus ball, final shot of the tournament. The count is nine and the final tally is 213. In fact, he's still got one more. I'm getting ahead of myself. Now, this is the bonus ball. But whatever way you look at it, and now everybody feverishly calculating If Frank Berner has enough already in the bank, and I think he probably has, that wraps it up. That is the nine count. And it's all over. The spares kept coming. There were no open frames, but 2-1-3. I'm afraid the ratio of strikes simply wasn't enough. So Lintilä and coach Varaninen shake their heads in disappointment. And Frank Berner, having done my mental arithmetic on the run, so to speak, and I think we've got it correct, needs 9 pins to win. And thank goodness our official scorer agrees with me. Yes, there it is. It's up above the bowlers' heads now. They can see it as well. They're locked into the game. They know exactly what they need to do. Just like darts players, their mental arithmetic is immaculate and lightning quick. So 9 pins for the title here in Vienna. It goes to the German. He's the first German winner out on the tour this season. And he's broken the Scandinavian stranglehold on this season's Golden Bowling Ball Tour. And he's right back to his best, a winner last year in Dresden. Frank Berner has done it the hard way, overcoming the Iceman from Finland. Well, well done to Berner, because Lintilä certainly didn't throw it away. But this is turning out to be a superb score. In fact, he's going to pace around the 245, 250 mark. That's fantastic bowling by anybody's standards. To do that in league week by week in Germany is one thing. To do that in international matches over the course of 5 days is another. But to do that as a one-off in a grand final in front of a huge audience and the TV cameras as well, when you've come into the final cold as top seed, no time to warm up, but look at that, 2-4-7, plays 2-1-3, and Frank Berner is the master in Vienna. Fantastic stuff. The big four bagger was a brilliant recovery from the open he had in frame two. And Lintilä has to take second place ahead of Johan Damberg and Bodo Konietzny from Berlin in fourth. Well, Berner just kept on striking. It was Lasser who cracked first in the crucial ninth. And that 10th frame turkey was Frank's final tour de force here at the US Play Center in the shadow of the famous big wheel of Vienna. The big shot on tour stop number 3 in our men's final has been Frank Berner, the first German to win ahead of the Scandinavian challenge. It hasn't changed things too much around in the Masters ranking. Damberg comes into second place. And Frank Berner now makes an appearance in the top 10 as well after his magnificent performance today, getting
into position 5.
Well, the question to Frank was, how hard is it to come in cold when your opponent's already played 3 games back-to-back? Lasset showed a great striking ability in the first 2 games. Did you expect to win? He said it's not possible to forecast a victory against a player like the experienced Lasse. I did my best. It's always something special to play in a TV final, and I'm delighted to have carried the day. And that just about sums it up. I think from all the bowlers here in Vienna, from our organisers, our sponsors Brunswick, and from myself, Phil Meissen, it really has been quality bowling to remember. You are seeing the finest exponents of the game here on Eurosport. We thank you for your interest and look forward to seeing you out again soon on the 1998-99 Golden Bowling Ball Brunswick Tour.